Hey everybody, welcome to another week here at Get Quirked. We are going to go over how to use the data that we have been collecting with your Facebook pixel on your website, your landing page, wherever it is that you've been driving traffic over the last week, and use that data to really form some good audiences and show you exactly how this is so super powerful, because when you are using these audiences, you know that they are at least warm. They're interested in your product, they're interested in your service, because they've already been to your website, they've already looked at your offer. Maybe in some cases, they've taken you up on a specific offer and you're trying to get them to that next step, that next level. So that's what we're gonna do today. We're gonna set that up. So stay tuned to the very end of the video where I'm gonna give you a very special offer. I kinda hope this doesn't blow up because it could literally steal all of my time. So stick around to the end of the video and be sure to like and subscribe for a chance to get something really awesome. All right, so let's get into it. All right, here we are over on the computer, and to get started, we're gonna go ahead and set up a custom audience, and that way that we can actually start looking at the audience, see what kind of traffic we're getting, and learn a little bit more about that Facebook pixel conversion event. So let's get into that, and we're gonna start by logging into Business Manager, business.facebook.com. When you log in, you'll probably be on the Business Manager page, so it'll look a little something like this. And we want to go up to the top left-hand corner again, as always. Click on that Business Manager little drop-down window and go over to All Tools. And what we're looking for is in the Assets column, it's our audiences. We're going to build a custom audience real quick for this offer that we're driving people to. So we will create a custom audience, and we want to base it off of website traffic. And we are going, we're using the wrong pixel, so let's use the right pixel. There we go. Create audience, custom audience, website traffic, and we want to change this from anyone who visits your website to people who visited specific web pages. And we're going to make sure that this URL equals, and I've already copied it in, and so we'll just paste that there, and that is the URL for our three-step guide. And we're gonna look anytime in the last 30 days. We're gonna give this a name, so three-step guide visitors. Create the audience. Audience is ready. It's gonna tell us that it's too small. That's because we've got, they think under 20 people, but really Facebook just kinda needs some time to adjust to that. Sometimes they get it right off the bat. Sometimes it takes 24 hours to really see that traffic. But also, we haven't driven a whole lot of traffic to this. So we'll see here, if you get this little flag, audience too small, mouse over this little guy, audiences must include at least 20 people to be used for ads. Well, I know for a fact that we've had more than 20 people visit that page, so we're just gonna give that some time. One little thing that is gonna be awesome for you guys is to create a lookalike audience based off of these people. So I'll go ahead and select this, and we're gonna go to Actions, Create a Lookalike. Now, we want this as our source. We want our location to be United States. For you guys, it might be different. And we wanna build our lookalike audience into about 1% of the total population on Facebook within this country. So within the US, we're gonna look at 1%, which is gonna be about 2.1 million in this audience setup. So we can look at the advanced options, but we don't really need that. We only want that one audience. So let's just do that one. We'll create the lookalike audience, and that will take some time. So you can see it's not ready. It's updating the audience. What it's doing, it's taking our initial audience, our three-step guide visitors, and it's creating profiles on those people. And then it's going out to the rest of Facebook, the 1% of the US population that we chose, and it's finding people that look like the people who have already been to the three-step guide download page. Now, because our audience is kind of small to start with, we're not gonna get great traction on the lookalike audience, but it will give us a little bit better pool than if we were just running to completely cold traffic, not looking at any sort of targeting. So now we want to pop over to either the Power Editor or the Ads Manager. They're kind of the same these days. I think Facebook's really trying to push people into the Ads Manager as a whole. Power Editor lets you do a little bit more, but as Facebook grows and changes, they may just become one tool. So I'm in the Power Editor right here, and we can go ahead and create a new campaign. We're gonna call this 3-step download, and we want auction, it's fine. We want our campaign objective to be conversions, and we want to set up a new ad set. We'll call this 3-step DL, and we're going to run that to men on mobile. If I can type here. And we want to create a new ad. So we're going to do 3-step download offer. So we're going to create this. And now we actually get in here and we can edit certain things. I'm going to dive into the ad set immediately. And right here it's going to say, please select a conversion pixel. So we need to do that. So we're setting up a specific event source, and we're going to look at the complete registration pixel. And that's what we're going to actually be targeting. So this is the event that we want people to actually hit. We want that to fire. And what that will be is when they get here, they put in their info, they click get your guide now, and they move over. I've already done this. So they move over to the thank you page, and now you can see that our event has fired. So that's the information that we want, and we want to be able to use that as kind of a tag of sorts. So Facebook is going to use that tag. They're going to kind of cookie the user, and then when that person gets back on Facebook, they'll be able to find, or if they're already logged into Facebook, Facebook will start collecting data about those people. And that's where this is so powerful, because on Facebook, you like things, you join groups, you use certain language, you post certain media, you share things, you like to look at certain stuff. Facebook tracks all that stuff. And we as marketers and advertisers can use that data to better inform our advertising campaigns. This is why Facebook is so powerful, and why you can spend so little money right now on a small segment of people and see a huge return. That's why it's so powerful. So we'll pop back over to the Power Editor and finish building out this guy. So we want our, let's do this in a lifetime budget. We'll spend $50 on driving some traffic there. We will run it for, let's do a whole, let's see. So we're starting today. We're gonna run it for, oh, that's why. We're gonna run it for 1 week. And we'll go ahead and set this to 11:59 p.m. Run that through the end of next Tuesday. And we don't have our custom audience really set up quite yet. It's still pulling just directly from this guy saying we've got less than 20 people. So let's do this anyway. Let's see if it works. Estimates for audience are unavailable, probably because it's still being set up. Run it to 25 to 65 plus men, English speakers, English US. We could do all, it really doesn't matter, but yeah, let's get hyper specific here. And then we can move into our ad and create our ad. Come on. All right, we've got our video. And we want to make sure that our thumbnail is selected, and it is. So as you can see that we are still running to all of these different placements. We'll go back and fix that in a minute. But right now, we want to run this to a website URL. And let's see, the video's already got captions, so we don't have to worry about that. Can add some text into the video. Still not using Facebook to grow your business? ? Download our 3-step guide to growing your business using Facebook today and start seeing results within 7 days. All right, so we'll see our preview here. For mobile, this guy doesn't really matter. So let's just say grow and engaged just do grow in 7 days or less. How's that? All in 7 days or less. There we go. So for a call to action button, yes, we are offering a download, but learning more is something that people are more willing to do than immediately download. So let's stick with learn more as our call to action button there. And you can see that in the ad preview. So we are tracking via the Facebook Pixel. We've got our ad pretty much good to go here. And so the last thing to really do before we publish it is to make sure that our targeting and our placements is actually set up properly. So we'll go back into our ad set and see we've got automatic placements. That's going to run in literally every location that Facebook has to market to. So we want to make sure that we're only using Facebook and Instagram. And we want to make sure that we are using not the right column, not instant articles. We only want to target the feed in both Instagram and Facebook. So now we are good to go on that. We can even switch to mobile only, which is what we actually wanted to target. And yeah, so there we go. So we're all set up. We'll go ahead and review the changes. This will take a little bit. So you can keep working. Facebook will manage this stuff in the background and it'll let us know when the ads are approved. So once this is approved, we can go take a look at that. And as we start running traffic to it, we'll see what that data is collecting and how the Facebook algorithm for the ads is actually working to our favor because we are using that conversion event. While we wait for this guy, let's go ahead and pop back over to our business manager. And then over to our page, and we'll go ahead and do something very similar to that ad we just created. But this is yet another way to use the conversion, use the audiences that we're building to target people a lot better. So we can do this in a couple ways. We could do a new post, but let's go ahead and start with a post that already exists that is getting some good traffic and traction. Load, load, load. All right, so here we go. This is a post that we did about our video from last week. So let's go ahead and boost that post and we'll get this dialog box up here. So people you choose through targeting, you can see here, here's our custom audience. Here is our lookalike. Let's do this. So that's too small. So it's still processing. We're gonna do it anyway. So we don't want to run the promotion on Instagram. We want our total budget to be, we'll do 10 bucks, not 210, 10 bucks. We're going to run that for 7 days. We want to track our conversions. This is where this stuff comes in handy. So basically when we're doing this from, you know, boosting a post and driving traffic to our offers that way, then we know that we're getting people from different sources so that Facebook can actually learn a little bit more about specific people that are seeing this and that they're going there. It's all about, you know, dialing in those audiences, dialing in those conversion events so that Facebook can really know who it needs to target within your target audience to specifically take you up on your offer, whatever it is you're offering. So there we go. And we're gonna go ahead and boost that. All right, so they're reviewing the order. Yeah, I guess it takes less than 15 minutes. So we'll check in on that again, but I want to run a new post. So let's do this. We're going to add some media here. So we actually want to use the image here. All right, so basically we want to look at our campaign and our ad. And we want to edit this. Oh, come on. We want to edit this so that we can see exactly what we did. So basically we are taking the headline, we're going to make that our first thing that people see. We're going to make this all one line so that Facebook doesn't truncate our link, especially on mobile. On mobile, you are limited to what Facebook shows by default in the text area. That's why video is so powerful. That's why images are so powerful. And we're just going to kind of tweak the copy in the post so that people are enticed by this. Even if they see a shortened version of the URL, they'll still be able to click it. If they want to see more and read more of this stuff to learn a little bit more about the guide, not a big deal. So one thing that we can do is choose the preferred audience for this post. That's where we can get into our preferred audiences, and we can build a new custom audience based on this. So, and we'll go ahead and save that. So these are the types of people that this stuff is going to go out to, and we can either publish it or schedule it to post in the future. I want to make sure that this actually goes out to people though and gets a good boost. So let's go ahead and boost this, and we're going to target our lookalike again. And again, it's still telling us too small, whatever, doesn't matter. Do 10 bucks, we'll run it for one day, and there we go. Set our budget, we'll go ahead and schedule this to post. So there we are. Now that we've done that, we've gone over a couple different ways that you can use your conversion events by building audiences, running traffic to those events, and collecting all that data. I know we've kind of bounced around a lot, but really the core concepts that you want to know are getting the pixel set up, making sure that you're tracking the right events, and then when you get to wanting to spend a little bit of money on Facebook to do this advertising, you can do that. You can target those exact events, you can target your daisy chain of events if you have a lead magnet into a tripwire, into a high ticket sale, then you can track each step, you can see the action on the pixel at each step, and understand where you're kind of falling off. You know, your actual conversions will tell you a good bit about that, but the actual conversions don't really happen on Facebook. So Facebook needs these events to fire so that it understands this is an exact thing that I want you to track. This is the information I'm looking for you to tell me more about. And that's how it's gonna be super powerful for your business, because you're gonna get, again, those highly specific, warm audiences that you can run even more traffic to in the future. So I hope this has been informative. There we go. Facebook pixel setup, audience creation, and even running some ads. So I think you guys are on your way. Thank you guys so much for sticking around to the very end. As promised, here's your special offer. I'm gonna pick one person who has liked this video, commented below, and subscribed to our channel here at Get Quirked. And I'm gonna run through your Facebook pixel with you and give you some pointers on what I think you can do as far as building an offer around that to try and drive more traffic, to strategize for retargeting these people. And that's usually about a $1,500 consultation, giving it away for free. So this is gonna be awesome. Just be sure to like the video, comment below, and subscribe to the channel to be entered to win this giveaway. I guess it's a giveaway. That's all we need. Just like, comment, and share. Like, comment, and subscribe. I mean, share it too. That'd be awesome. So I will announce the winner here on YouTube. I'll do a short YouTube live to announce that winner. So be sure to tune in to that. Make sure you've got notifications turned on for the Get Quirked channel after you've subscribed so that you know when we are going live. I will also kind of simulcast that on Facebook and on Instagram. So if you are following us on those platforms as well, be sure to turn your notifications on there too. So now that you've got your Facebook pixel set up, your data aggregating, and you know exactly what to do with it, that's awesome. Thank you so much for sticking around. I'll see you next week. I am Matt from Get Quirked, and you guys keep being awesome.